Hey guys, I'm Bhavin here from taxupdata.com. In this video, I will show you how to create a Flashlight application in Ionic Framework 1. Okay, so let's stay tuned with me. I'll be show you step by step how to make a Flashlight application within a 10 minutes. Okay, so first of all, you have need some of our tool which is in, installed in your system pre-built it. So let's first you have to install a Node.js inside your system. So I have already opened the link Node.js.org. You have to install a latest version of Node.js. I have already installed in my system, that's why I skip this step. But you have to download the Node.js and install inside your system. After installing a Node.js, you have to just open a command prompt and write a Node, and you will get the Node.js command prompt here. Just open the command prompt and type, if you want to check which versions you have already installed in your system, just Node and -v, which is basically a command to check the which versions right now you have inside your system in the Node.js. Okay, so just write, and I have a 6.11, which is the latest version. You can see the right now recommended for every user. There are two versions basically, which is current, and it's right now this is in development state, and this is a stable. So we use always a stable step of the Node.js. Okay, so after installing the Node.js, you will get this 6.11. If you don't get this versions, then you must have some skip some of the step in the installation. So please uninstall the Node.js and reinstall with the correct way. That's you will get the correct version of the Node.js. After installing the Node.js, you must have to download Ionic and Cordova inside your system. Ionic basically one kind of library that gives you developing a mobile applications kind of platforms. So going to the installation step for Ionic 1 installations, and you will get the link of the Ionic 1, and make sure that right now Ionic working on the three versions, right? Version 1, version 2 and version 3. So must you right now we are developing the application inside the Ionic version 1, so you must have to select the Ionic 1 framework docs. So basically when you open this website, it basically redirect to Ionic 3, but right now we are developing the application in Ionic version 1. So and go to the overview tab, and you will get here the command which gives you download the Ionic framework inside your system. So this is basically first command, that Ionic install. This command basically install Ionic inside your system and globally. Hyphen G basically used for the global level. So we need Cordova as well. So we type npm install hyphen G Cordova and Ionic and hit enter. After installing hit enter, you will get that downloading whole Ionic framework then as well as Cordova. So you need to wait for a few seconds, and depending on your internet connections, it will be take a 5 minute and 10 minutes according to your internet speed. So you have to wait for a few seconds. After successful installations of the Cordova and Ionic, so yeah, we have download whole the Cordova and Ionic framework. You can see it here. Okay, so right now we have Ionic installed in our system. So now we have to type second command, which is basically start our new project. So one thing that I would like to tell you about it, here is a type Ionic 1. Basically this is identification that you are developing this application inside the version 1. There is a vast difference between version 1 and version 2 and version 3 in the Ionic framework. So basically version 1 use the older version of AngularJS and older versions of Ionic. So right now if you are if you don't specify this type Ionic 1 flag, so it will automatically download the latest versions, which is right now Ionic 3 and latest version of the repository. So you will get type scripts and component, all these things, which is a different you know, kind of folder structures and directory structures and different kind of the syntax of the code. So there is a vast difference between Ionic 1 and Ionic 3. So if you want to develop Ionic application in your version 2 and 3, then you have to specify using this flag. So right now we are developing application inside the Ionic version 1, so we specify this type Ionic 1. So let's start with Ionic start, basically a command that start your applications, and we give our name, project name is Flashlight, and we use a blank template. So we use a blank flag, which is basically three templates which is provided by the Angular. So we use a blank, and then we use a and we do some coding on the blank template. And double hyphen type Ionic 1 and hit enter. So it will be downloading the whole the repository from the server using this Flashlight app. You can see here downloading this progress. So we have to wait for a few seconds. It will be download according to your internet connection speed. Yeah, we download the blank template and download all the plugins. Right now downloading the basic plugins that required for the Ionic applications. So yeah, we download almost all these things, which is right now basically npm install, which install a package which is required for our application. There we go. Right now our applications, you can see here how the process happened, and successfully we download our first blank template. So we are just giving a no, we don't require any kind of the dashboard. Okay, so right now we have a Flashlight application. You can see our C drive directory. We move over the C drive and user and public, and we have a downloaded, sorry, XO. We have downloaded Flashlight application. I've created one folder, Flashlight. Yeah. So this is our application which is recently downloaded from the server. So right now we have to develop a Flashlight application over bottom of this code. So right now we just use V code. So this application open inside the Visual Studio code, which is basically a text editor that we need to require for these applications. We open this code it here. C drive, user, and Flashlight. Yeah. Basically, we load our project inside this. That's all right. So, as you know about applications, if you don't know about the directory structure, then you visit my YouTube channel. I have already some of our video, which is basically explained you how to identify which directory basically used for which purpose. So okay, so we basic setup inside our applications. So right now we need to download Ionic, right? Ionic plugin, sorry, ng cordova plugins. So we just write the ng cordova. Basically a plugin which gives a native functionality of your application. So ng cordova already have one plugin which is called as a Flashlight. So just we need to download. First of all, we need to install ng cordova inside our project. So just open ng cordova website and docs and installations, and use this bower command. Just copy this command and open this place, and inside your project file Flashlight, just paste your code, right? Hit enter. So it will be basically download this ng cordova inside your project. You can see your bower dependency, it will be installed. So we have a bower installed inside our system. So right now we have to include this two file inside our main index.html. So just go to there, and you can see here in the library folder we have a ng cordova. So yeah, we installed ng cordova, and right now we have to just copy this index dependency file and paste above the index.html, which is in the root directory. So we include ng cordova inside of Ionic application. Then the next step we have to include inside our main module, which is injections of the ng cordova, right? Inside the app.js, we just include So right now ng cordova perfectly work in our system. So yeah, this is a step where how we can integrate and install other plugins. So right now we go to the Vionic, inside your plugin tab. You can see here, these are the plugin which we can easily integrate and easily install inside of Vionic applications. So right now we have flashlight. Yeah, we have a flashlight plugin here. And just use this command to download this plugin inside our projects. So just copy this whole line and you can paste it here and hit enter. So this will download ngcode or plugin inside our project. So until this download, we have just set up our controller and go through with the code, right? So we have a run file, so we need to controller. Yeah, we have our new controller, main controller, and we integrate a scope inside this one. So right now we just use our controller inside our index.html. So inside our content, we have a center tag, and we just have a center, and we have a three button. We have to button class button. btn team, right, button, and we have a on, which is basically op on our flashlight. Right, we have a three button inside our system, and we just use ng click for when the user click on this button, we need to perform some action. So this class ng click, we just on function, call on function, call off function, off app controller, and on off. So basically we have defined three function it here, on, off, and on off, right? So according to, we just define it here, our ng controller is equal to which is our main controller, which is main controller. Yeah, this name should be a similar to this name. Yeah, okay. So we successfully integrate our applications. So right now we are just move over the, yeah, we successfully installed our plugin. We need to inject a Cordova flashlight inside our controller right here. After the injections, we have to check, this is basically use if mobile device have flashlight or not. This is basically check for availability, and these are the main three function which gives us the on off and toggling functionality of our applications. We just copy this code and paste inside the applications, and we bind all these things inside our function. So just use a scope dot on is equal to function. Yeah, we just copy this code inside our right. We have a successfully defined on function as well. Scope dot off function and same. Basically off the component. Yeah, this is a for toggle. So just scope dot on off function this for toggling off applications. We need to remove this because we already, yeah. Yeah, we go. We created a on function, off function, and on off function. And according to, we just bind this function inside our view using this on off and on off functions. So, okay, so flashlight applications almost ready. We just need to click in these functions and it will be called native device flashlight, and it will be op, on off and according to on off. Okay, so right now we saw this application inside our browser. So just click Ionic saw, basic command that run your application inside the browser. So you can see our applications start successfully. We have a three button on, off, and on off. Right now this is not working because we have a browser, we open this application inside the browser. So we need a real mobile device, real device to test this application. So if you want to check it out, this work perfectly or not, you just inspect element, and inside the console we just get this error. That's error basically show you that the flashlight is not detecting inside your application. So you must have to need this run this application inside your real device. That's why we easily get this command to detect the flashlight from your application. So yeah, that's it. That is all for from flashlight applications. You just need to build this application inside the APK, and just you will run this application inside your mobile device. Okay, so if you have any query, if you have any doubts, so please comment inside the below of this video. And have a nice day. Thank you very much for watching this video. And don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel.